Again, I ask you, evaluate yourselves. Numbers 26 to 12. Moses and Aaron went from the assembly to the entrance to the tent of meeting, and fell face down, and the glory of the Lord appeared to them. The Lord said to Moses, "Take the staff, and your brother Aaron, gather the assembly together, speak to that rock before their eyes, and it will pour out its water. You bring water out of the rock for the community, so they and the livestock can drink." So Moses took the staff from the Lord's presence, just as he commanded him. He and Aaron gathered the assembly together in front of the rock, and Moses said to them, "Listen, you rebels, must we bring you water out of this rock?" Then Moses raised his arm and struck the rock twice with his staff. Water gushed out, and the community and the livestock drank. But the Lord said to Moses and Aaron, "Because you do not trust in me enough to honor me as holy in the sight of the Israelites, you will not bring this community into the land I give them." Once again, Israel complains about the lack of water, and they direct their anger again at Moses and Aaron, as was their habit. Numbers 14, 5, 10, 16, verse 4, 19, and 22. Both prophet and priest fell prostrate before God at the tent of meeting. God had instructed Moses to take Aaron's rod and speak to the rock, demanding water to flow in full view of the congregation. Instead of just speaking to the rock, however, he struck the rock twice with Aaron's staff. The Lord graciously provided water, but for the lack of trust, he would not allow Aaron and Moses to enter the promised land. James 1, 5-8. If any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you. But when you ask, you must believe and not doubt, because the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea blown and tossed by the wind. That person should not expect to receive anything from the Lord. Such a person is double-minded and unstable in all they do. So, people of God, I must ask you again, evaluate yourselves. If you have any lack of trust, repent and begin to trust in God, Elohim, completely, in all his promises, in his word, and in his truth, so that you too may go into the promised land. We must remember what the works of the flesh are, what their fruits are: enmity, gossip, addiction, fight, disobedience, envy, doubt, lie, and grudges. Let us instead lean on these fruits, the fruits of the Spirit: kindness, goodness, peace, joy, faithfulness, gentleness, love, patience, and self-control. Many blessings and shalom, brothers and sisters. I love you.